Hello Red Devils, MUFC Legend here, and I'm back again with another video. So, Manchester United play Chelsea in the FA Cup final. It's an absolutely brilliant chance for Manchester United to get a trophy this season. Okay, it's the FA Cup, but you know, every trophy matters. And hopefully, you know, Man United win the FA Cup, Liverpool lose against Real Madrid in Champions League, and that would be a good season for us overall. I wouldn't say it's a fantastic season, obviously not, because we haven't won the Premier League. But we're in the rebuilding process, and while we're winning cups, while rebuilding, which is fantastic. But hopefully next season, Manchester United do win the Premier League, because it's been a long time, and we have to win it now to reinstate, you know, our status as England's best club. So yeah, Manchester United vs Chelsea in the FA Cup final. Now, in my opinion, Chelsea will obviously play a back three, or a back five, shall we say. And that's why I think Mourinho should not do that. Mourinho should not play three at the back to match Chelsea, because what that means is Chelsea have an extra defender, so they have an extra less person outfield. So if Mourinho does play four at the back with Man United, we have an extra player in midfield and in attack against Chelsea's. And I think that would be the key battle, and we should be able to overrun them in the midfield area, and then obviously, you know, overrun them in attack as well. So anyway, let me get straight into the predicted lineup for Manchester United. So David De Gea in goal, best goalkeeper in the world, has saved us many points this season, and he's just a fantastic, fantastic player and a person. And in my opinion, next season he should be getting the captain's armband. Now left back, I'm gonna go with Ashley Young, because in finals Ashley Young does play quite well. You know, he plays with the passion and desire, and Mourinho loves that when a players play with passion and desire, and that's what Ashley Young does. So Ashley Young, left back, and alongside him, controversially, I am picking Chris Smalling, because recently, you can't deny that Chris Smalling has been on form. I've said it many times before this season that Smalling is not good enough for Manchester United, but recently, he has been on form, so you know, I would just play him. He played well against Tottenham, so I would just play him again in the FA Cup final. He deserves it because of his form. But one player I would not play is Phil Jones. He always, you know, has a mistake in him more than Chris Smalling. Jones just worries me, and Chris Smalling this season is a fun fact, thanks to Statman Dave. Chris Smalling has made zero Premier League errors that leads to goals this season, which is the best obviously in the Premier League for a defender. So that's absolutely fantastic to hear that, you know, Smalling, although his passing isn't that great, defensive wise he has been quite good recently, so let's just keep him in the squad. And alongside him, Eric Bailly. I thought he played fantastically in the last match against Watford. And I think Eric Bailly should be starting for Manchester United. He's our best defender by miles. And if Eric Bailly stays fit, unfortunately this season he didn't stay that fit. He had constant injuries that were, you know, troubling his season. But if he does stay fit and can play nearly every single match for us like Matic next season, I have no doubt that Man United can form a strong, you know, a very, very strong battle for the Premier League. This season, it wasn't that strong. We're 19 points behind, you know, Man City, which is absolutely embarrassing for Manchester United. You know, Manchester City absolutely dominate everyone in the Premier League. But next season, we need to keep our best players fit. And hopefully, Eric Bailly does stay fit, because he's the best defender at Manchester United. Now, right back, Antonio Valencia has been very consistent. Although his crossing is very, very poor, his defensive capabilities and his pace and his strength, you know, make him a good defender. And he has been quite consistent this season. He has come up with a lot of goals. For example, against Arsenal. And his volley against Everton, I think it was, which was absolutely brilliant. So Valencia has been a mainstay this season. But that's one key area I think Manchester United should be addressing in the summer. We need to get a functional right back, a functional left back, and another centre back to partner Eric Bailly. Now, in centre defensive mid, obviously there's no other person than Nemanja Matic. He's been arguably one of our best players this season. So consistent. He's a, you know, mainstay in this team, and he's just a building block to which the Manchester United players and the team should build around Matic, because he's absolutely brilliant. He's, you know, obviously he's old, but he has played a lot of games this season and he hasn't looked tired. He's looked tired a couple of times, but not, you know, throughout the course of the season he has been very, very good. So Nemanja Matic. Alongside him, Ander Herrera, he's come in 4-3-3 midfield and he's looked quite sharp and, you know, ready to play. So Ander Herrera should be starting alongside Paul Pogba in a three-man midfield. So Matic, Herrera and Pogba. I think that's, you know, right now that's our best midfield trio. And next season we need to obviously improve our midfield. We need to improve on Fellaini and improve on actually replace Carrick as well. And the two main midfield targets for Manchester United are Milinkovic-Savic and Fred from Shakhtar Donetsk. And Milinkovic-Savic is from Lazio. And I think the quality midfielders, if Manchester United can buy both of them and add a bit of quality, not a bit actually, add a lot of quality to this team and the squad, that would be fantastic. But yeah, Paul Pogba, he has been very inconsistent this season. But hopefully, the good Paul Pogba shows up against Chelsea in the FA Cup final and he produces on the big stage, like he did in the Europa League. Now, on to the left-wing position. Obviously, Alexis Sanchez has to start. His work rate is phenomenal. And it's only a matter of time before he starts banging in goals for Manchester United. He just needs that kind of consistency. He came in halfway through the season, so it is understandable. Like Patrice Evra, he struggled as well when he first came in halfway through the season. And Nemanja Vidic, he struggled halfway through the season when he came in January. And they, you know, they struggled as well. But the next season, they were absolutely fantastic. That's what I think is going to happen with Alexis Sanchez. Once Man United sort their transfers out, you know, get a good left-back, right-back, and a very good midfielder in terms of Milinkovic-Savic or Fred, I think Alexis Sanchez will start seeing the, you know, attacking capabilities. And obviously, Jesse Lingard has to start. He produces in big games at Wembley. Wembley is Jesse Lingard's, you know, ground. He owns that place. He's come up with the goods every time at Wembley. For example, in Leicester, against Leicester in the Community Shield, in the FA Cup final under Louis van Gaal. And he's just a brilliant big team, big match player, Jesse Lingard. The runs in behind he makes is fantastic. And the pressure he adds on the opponents is very, very good. And Chelsea are very, very vulnerable when they are pressured. So Manchester United should just go all out and pressurize them. And, you know, they make them force errors. And Jesse Lingard and hopefully Sanchez will be there. And obviously up front, there has been news that Romelu Lukaku will be fit for the FA Cup final. So Romelu Lukaku up front. Romelu Lukaku has improved drastically this season. In the first couple of games, he was scoring, but his overall play wasn't that good. But as the season's gone on, he's been a fantastic player for us. You know, he's up there with Matic as one of our best performers this season. And De Gea. And Romelu Lukaku, honestly, he has surprised me by how much he has improved. He has improved by a lot. And, you know, that's saying something to him. That's down to his hard work, you know, and credit to him because he's joined Man United and he's put in the hard work. And I do believe Lukaku can, you know, score many, many goals for us next season. But it's literally next season is based off the transfers that Man United pull off this summer. We need quality additions to match Manchester City quality. So we need quality players in the right positions and we should be able to challenge for the Premier League next season. But for the FA Cup final, I think this team is more than good enough, more than capable enough of beating Chelsea and lifting that FA Cup trophy. It would be fantastic, hopefully, if Manchester United do win. And I am predicting that Manchester United will win. I think it will be a, you know, a good performance overall because Chelsea are vulnerable. As I've said before, they're in bad form. So Manchester United should just, you know, come out of the blocks and just pressurize them. And I think, hopefully, it's going to be, you know, an entertaining performance by Manchester United. And I think I'm predicting it's going to be around 2-0 to Manchester United within 90 minutes. Obviously, the FIFA video went to extra time, if you did see that video. But that was obviously FIFA. I'm predicting in real life that Manchester United will win 2-0. Goals from Romelu Lukaku and, let me say, Jesse Lingard. So, Lukaku and Lingard to score 2-0 to Manchester United. And we won the FA Cup. And in my opinion, that's been an overall good season. I am going to make a season overview, a season review video very, very soon. But I've got exams recently. That's why I've been not uploading that consistently. But once my exams finish, I will start uploading a lot of matches. And I will be covering the pre-season matches as well. So the predicted lineups for the pre-season matches. Although it will be difficult, I'll try my best for them. But anyways, this is the team I would like to see Mourinho put out against Chelsea in the FA Cup final, and I believe Manchester United will win the FA Cup. So anyways, let me know what you think about this team in the comments below. Let me know your score predictions in the comments below. It's been MUFC Legend, and I'll see you guys later.